Well, Gilly, for the second week running, we are at Webby's Bar, but the host isn't home. He is still crook. He is, well, he's phoned it in from his hospital bed. You got off your hospital bed to play at Origin, but he's just phoning his tips in. So let's get into it. Round 24. Actually, he's got you by a point.
Yeah.
1 point coming into it with 4 weeks
to
go.
What's that, Chuck? Dun, dun, dun. I'm just coming, mate. I'm just coming.
That won't make him get out of bed any quicker. Yeah, yeah. All right, let's go straight up. For Thursday night, it is top of the ladder. The minor premiership could be decided. Penrith and the Storm.
How good would this game be?
Oh, a belter.
I'd actually love to see it like at a Sunday afternoon game. That's what I'd love to see.
Rather than a Thursday night in Penrith.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Anyway. Well, you played at Penrith. What is a night game there in the middle of August like?
It's cool.
Yeah. Well, hang on, but it is Melbourne, though, right? So does it matter?
No, exactly. The Storm players would be used to it, no doubt about that. But Sunday afternoon, I just love the feeling and everyone walking to the grounds and stuff like that. And just, Suncorp and that Sunday Arvo, I love it.
But they're playing Thursday night, so who's going to win?
So who cares? Yeah. So get off the subject.
Get off the subject.
How good was that, Penrith? 3 tries in 7 minutes against Parramatta, and that's the local derby, so both clubs don't like each other very much.
Well, hang on, how good? It's Parramatta.
They've got nothing to play for, Parramatta.
Yeah.
That would have been their grand final for them, so I think it was a pretty fair effort. But, 36-34, I don't think... the coach would have been too happy with the 34 points. For Penrith.
So. You're going Penrith. Webby is going the Melbourne Storm. Yeah. So he's going for an upset straight away. He's either going to increase his lead or you're going to catch him on this one, the first game of the round. So he thinks the Storm can seal the minor premiership, which you'd have to think that'll be done this weekend, wouldn't it?
Well, close to it. Yeah.
Yeah?
I think it will be.
Yeah, all right. Unconvincing, though. The 12-point winners over South, but he's still phoned it in to say that that the Storm are going to get over Penrith.
Well, bellyache and, he always sticks solid with his mates, bellyache, Wayne... it's all that type of thing.
Oh, so he's tipping with his heart and not his head. Okay. It's going to be an absolute belter to kick things off. Round 24. Friday, then we go to Brookvale, and it's Manly hosting the Wars. Who do you like here, Gilly?
Yeah, mate, I'm going Manly. And we're both going Manly.
So that's the build-up. That's where you tease it. I was going to come in and say, Webby's with you.
Okay.
But anyway, you're both going Manly over the Wars. Yeah, exactly.
But, the Dolphins just snuck home. Sean O'Sullivan's field goal, 40 metres out, 2-point field goal for the Dolphins to beat the Warriors, last weekend. So, I'm going to go Manly. I think they're starting to fire a little bit. DCE, how good's he playing? I'll rephrase this. Yeah. I thought he was pretty quiet in the first half last week. But the second half was very good, so it's good to see.
Yeah, well, they toweled up the Raiders. What was it? 46-24 Manly. It's 6-14. That's why Webby's also going to the home side there. Then we go to Friday night, the second game. It is the Roosters at the Sydney Football Stadium or Allianz Stadium up against the aforementioned Parramatta Eels, who were run down by the Panthers. Chooks in third spot. You've got to be going them, don't you?
Of course you have.
Yeah.
Parramatta will have a crack, but they haven't got the firepower the Roosters have, and too much to play for the Roosters. They would have got themselves up to play Penrith last week, Parramatta. I don't think they can do it again.
We can't replicate it again. Well, you want to hope not, because the Broncos next game after the bye next week would be Parramatta, and they'd hate to run into them with their tail up. Roosters coming off a bye, so both have tipped the Roosters over Parramatta. Let's take a look. Saturday in Bundaberg, Gilly.
Did
you ever play at Salter Oval in Bundaberg?
I had a trial game there a long time ago, but it was...
What's it like?
Oh, it was a good ground. Yeah. Bundy, they love their footy there. And, I remember even at the Broncos, we used to go to some of the country areas for trial games. And we went to Mackay a few times. We went out west a few times as well. So Emerald, I think we played it. No, that was at the Crushers. We played a trial.
That was your first ever game. Yeah, I was there.
Right. Yeah.
That's how old I am.
Yeah. Fair enough.
Olders, yeah.
older. I'm that, older than
big
you.
Big Garrick Morgan.
Yes, yes.
Mario.
Good days.
Yeah, there we go. But let's talk about Saturday afternoon at Bundaberg. It's a home game to the Bulldogs. They're taking on the Dolphins there. Now, the Dogs, we know, are flying. The Dolphins, they need to get the Finns flying. They're in eighth spot. They need to win this to stay in the eight.
Well, they just scraped home. We said that against the Warriors. So, but I think that might be a bit of a... like a springboard for them, I think the Dolphins, hopefully. But
yeah, give them that confidence.
But yeah. But I've gone the Dogs. So yeah. So
is this what Webby has to put up with?
Yeah. So I've gone the Dogs. Yeah. Only because they're playing good footy, honestly. And what they run a fifth and the best thing at the moment is Cameron Ciraldo's defence has finally kicked in this year. Mm. You know what I mean? On I reckon the last 4 or 5 weeks, the defence has got better and better. So, and he brought that from Penrith. So, yeah I think that'll happen.
Second best defence in the comp, which is really weird why Webby hasn't gone for the... it's that Wayne factor. He's gone the Dolphins. There we go.
Doesn't like getting Wayne's nose out of joint.
Predictable. But he has gone the Dolphins too. We'll jump on the back of that confidence you were speaking about, that 1-point win at Suncorp. All right, we're going to head to Townsville, the next game, the Cowboys and the Raiders. Again, this is a must-win for the Cowboys to stay in the eight. They're currently seventh. The Raiders knocking on the door in 11th.
I'm going the Cowboys. I let it out again.
You've got to build it up.
But I've got to go the Cows. But, I mean, geez, they were disappointing against the Broncos. Like, fair dinkum.
Well, their top four chances are gone now, haven't they?
Yeah. They're well and truly.
Yeah.
But, I mean... They look like one of the best teams in the comp 1 week and then one of the worst teams. You know, the consistency side of things. And Todd Payton would be filthy with that. So, it's a bit deflating when you see that sometimes for your teammates and that you're not playing the way you should be playing. So frustrating for them.
Yeah, well, Todd Payton said that there will be changes. They conceded 36 points, straight points. It's 11-7. It is the Cowboys taking on the Raiders. Yep. Both you and Webby have gone the Cowboys there. Saturday night, the third game in Super Saturday, off to Campbelltown. It is the Tigers and South. This is the Who Gives a Cup, Stuff Cup.
Yeah. Well, actually,
17th and 15th.
I nearly went the Tigers here, only because it was Campbelltown.
Did you go to Nimbin or something over the weekend?
I've had a few head knocks, you know that. I know they played the Storm and went okay, you know what I mean, so against the Storm. But, I'm thinking, you know, it'll be their last game at Campbelltown, I think, this year. So I was thinking the Tigers might like to finish off with a bang, but
I'm sure they would like to finish with a bang. But whether they will or not,
but I think Benji Marshall might give him a bang in the head later on. But we both gone South Sydney.
Yeah, there we go. So Gilly and Webby both tipping South there. So let's bring it home. Sunday afternoon, the penultimate game for the round, Trevor, is down in Wollongong. The Dragons hosting the Titans.
Yeah.
What do you like?
Well, I've gone the Dragons. Ooh. I mean, I want to go the Titans, but I mean...
Well, then why didn't you go the Titans?
Yeah, I know. But this year, Ben, if you're leading the... I've said this to you off air.
Yeah.
If you're leading the Timbered comp in the NRL or the AFL this year, you've got no idea. Honestly, please. I mean,
but this is a tipping segment.
I know, you've got to have an idea.
So are you doing a George Costanza? Everything you think I'm going to do, I'm going to go the opposite.
The opposite, yeah.
Right.
Yeah, call me George.
Okay, George. So who are you going? You're going the Dragons.
But how can I go the Titans when they got pumped 44-0 by the Sharks?
Yeah, but they pumped the Broncos 46-18 the week before.
I know. Yeah, and they beat the Warriors 66-6 this year as well. I'm getting that. So. I love the Titans to win, but I'm going the Dragons.
Yeah, well, you know who else would like the Titans to win? Webby, because he's tipped them. Yes. So there we go. So you have three different so far this round. So it'll either be a change of the lead or he will fly out. All right, let's bring it home. Shark Park, Sunday afternoon. Your Sunday afternoon footy wish. You like this. Yeah. This is the Sharks and the Knights. 4th v. 10th. The Knights still a chance for the finals, but the Sharks...
Yeah, they're sitting fourth, aren't they? Mm. And Shark Park, you know, Sunday Arvo, as again, mate, love that afternoon footy. It'll be a good game, this.
And they were the ones who put 44 points on the Titans.
Yeah, exactly, exactly. Yeah. Carlton Ponga has hit a bit of form again as well. But I just think, especially at home, Hines and Trindle should be back. Or I don't know, there's a bit of a talk that they could be out. I'm not real sure, but at the moment, if they're going to play. But I've got to go to the Sharkies at home.
All right, you're tipping the Sharks. So is Webby. So there you go. You see eye to eye on there. And the Broncos, they get the 2 points because they've got the bye. So
happy day.
Yes, if you buy into that theory that the Broncos could actually make the eight by getting maximum points for the next 4 weeks. Well, here's a tick straight away.
Well, I mean...
You tip them?
If they do...
You're on the bye. You tip them to get
I'm
the points?
I'm tipping this week. As I said, how do you work this competition out at the moment? I'm baffled, mate. It's like you win, I win. You know, you win, you let me win. And, mate, it's kind of the consistency side of the things. And your coaches, mate, no wonder where they end up, in nut houses sometimes, coaches. Because this is sending you to the nut house, this would be.
Webby, come back, please. How do you make it typical? This is a tipping segment.
You've got to know. You're the expert. But I'm not the expert. I'm just like fair dinkum.
Hang on, are you saying that if you win a tipping comp, you know nothing about it? And Webby's leading. Is that why you're saying it?
No, exactly. But I'll be leading next week. And then I'll say, great tipping, Gilly.
Catch you next week. Well, at least Webby will be back. Fingers crossed.
See ya.